Hello, welcome to lecture number 22 of the course Quantum Mechanics and Molecular Spectroscopy. In the last lecture, we looked at the relationship between the transient moment integral or the transient dipole with the Einstein's coefficients A and B. And we ended up with A equals to 2 pi nu cube divided by 3 epsilon naught h bar c cube into 2 mu z epsilon 1 whole square. This could also be written as 2 pi nu cube by 3 epsilon naught h bar c cube f mu z along epsilon direction 1 or I whole square. Okay, here I have assumed that the state 1 is identically equal to state I and state f is identically equal to state 2. So, which is nothing but looking at transition between state 1 or I to state 2 or f. Okay, similarly we have the absorption coefficient or the stimulated emission coefficient to be pi by 6 epsilon naught h bar square 2 mu z 1 whole square. Okay, this is along the dot product of. Now, it turns out that these two coefficients, okay, are related to the transient moment integral. All this is called transition dipole. And square of the transient dipole. Okay. Now, there are experimental quantities, the one you can easily measure and one should be equate to A and B. So, one such experimental quantity is the absorption coefficient. Okay. So, we will try to derive the relationship between the A and B, the Einstein coefficients A and B, and the absorption coefficient. Now, when we think of absorption, one thing that comes to our mind is the Lambert-Beer law. Okay, what does Lambert-Beer law says? Lambert-Beer law simply says that the I equals to, or I by I naught, okay, log of this is equal to epsilon CL. Okay, and log of I by I naught is also called absorption A. This is equal to epsilon C absorbance. So, this is absorbance and this is the extinction coefficient. Okay. So, extinction coefficient epsilon will have, okay, the units of mole inverse, meter inverse, okay, because absorbance by itself does not have any units. Slightly differently if I can write this relationship, so if I write log of I by I naught epsilon CL, so if I take, you know, exponential on both sides, okay, so this will be equal to I by I naught will be equal to 10 to the power of epsilon C. So we can always write I equals to I naught okay, 10 to the power of epsilon C L. Okay. Now, this is the form of the, so one can write a differential form. So, di equals to 2.303 epsilon, which is a function of nu, okay, C times I times dx. Okay, what is your length? Length is nothing but L is the length. So if you have going from, say, x1 to x2, this is going to be L. L is equal to modulus of x1 minus x2. Okay, so one, if you look at the differential form, okay, so this is nothing but differential form. Okay, so essentially comes from this equation. Or in fact, if you integrate, you will get back this equation. Okay. So the differential form of Lambert-Beer law will be nothing but minus di equals to 2.303 into epsilon of nu, C is the concentration, I is the intensity, dx. Okay. Now, let us assume that there are n number of molecules, in volume of centimeter cube. Okay? And that is going from initial state I to initial state F, final state F under the light condition. Okay? So your minus di will be equal to n times h nu. H nu is nothing but your energy, W Fi, that is the rate coefficient, into dx. Okay, so the absorption, the incremental absorption that will happen will depend on number of molecules, the energy at which, and it's the omega rate of absorption multiplied by dx. Okay, now minus di according to Lambert-Beer law will also be equal to 2.303 epsilon of nu C times I dx. Okay. Now you can see these two are equal. So this is right in terms of molecule and this is terms of Lambert-Beer law. So we can equate them. So n h nu W, that is a rate constant between F and I, rate of F. Okay, dx is redundant now because it's an incremental change. Eraser, you can remove that. Now, this will be equal to 2.303 epsilon of nu at this nu, and this nu are the same, C times I. So, I can write rate of absorption is equal to 2.303 epsilon nu C dot I divided by n h nu. Okay. Now, you can see that concentration is nothing but 1000 times n divided by na. N by na is number of moles. Isn't it? N by Na is the number. Na is Avogadro constant. And concentration is 1000 times because it is written in decimeter cube. Okay? So when I plug in that, so C is one. So what you get is WFI is equal to 2.303 epsilon of nu. This is 1000 times N. Okay, into I divided by n into na h nu, and this n and this na will cancel. So what you'll get, 1000 into 2.303 will give 2303 epsilon of nu I divided by N A H nu. Okay, that is your rate of absorption. So now the rate of absorption is given by WFI going from state I to state F. So this will be equal to 2303 epsilon of nu times intensity of light divided by Avogadro numbers H. H nu is where the energy is happening. Now this is a very simple equation, except that we need to now slightly rearrange this equation. Now before I go, I want to look at something. So let us suppose you have a molecule, you have a solution, okay, of some molecules, okay, and then you shine light. So you get I naught and you get back I. Okay. Now what happens is that if you record this solution, what you get, you get a band. So what you plot is absorbance A versus lambda. Okay. Now we know that absorption is nothing but epsilon CL. So if you know absorption, if you know the concentration, if you know the length, so epsilon will be equal to A divided by CL. Okay. So and we know lambda is equal to nu lambda is equal to C. So C nu is equal to C by lambda. So we know these two equations. So I can convert this plot as plot of epsilon of nu versus nu. Okay. So what I am trying to tell you here is that if I have an absorption band, okay, some molecule getting absorbed in solution, and which is generally plotted absorbance versus length, one can transform this using appropriate conversion factors, is that one can plot the same thing as nu versus epsilon of nu. This is just a different representation. Okay? So what you can get is that you can get the absorption coefficient or the extinction coefficient as a function of the wavelength or the frequency. Of course, wavelength and frequency are related with respect to the both multiplication of that is here. Okay. So one can always plot. Generally, we plot it like this. Okay. But one could also plot like this. Okay. Now, why I want to use it, I'll come to this little. But just remember that one can also plot an absorption spectrum as a function of nu, the epsilon nu. Okay. Now let us look at the equation that we had. We had the equation of rate equals to 2.303 epsilon of nu times I divided by N A H. Okay. Now the intensity of light I in any medium is given by U dot C by eta, okay, where U is the total energy density and C is speed of light and eta is refractiveness. Okay. Now, if I plug in that, then I'll get WFI equals to 2.303 epsilon of nu U dot C divided by N A H nu into eta. But the energy density U is given by integral over nu. Okay. Rho radiation nu d nu. That's the total energy. So if you want the total energy density, Okay, what you need is the energy density at each frequency, and you integrate over all the density. Okay, so when I use this, is you have WFI is equal to 2.3. Sorry, this is not 2.33, but it is. I'm sorry about this. So erase. It should be 2303. So the decimal doesn't exist. Okay. This is 2303 epsilon of nu. U, instead of U, I write, okay, I'll write it later, into C divided by Na H nu into eta. Integral over nu, nu radiation of nu d nu. Of course, this is not the right way to, because you see there is a nu here as well. Okay, so in principle, one should write it as 2303. See, because this also depends on nu. So this is actually wrong way of writing. Okay, now because this is integral over nu, any quantity that has nu must be inside that integral. So 2.303 C divided by Na H eta integral over nu rho radiation nu epsilon nu by nu d nu. So that's the right way to write, okay? Even because you are integrating over all the values. So any variable that has nu dependence must be integrated, okay? So the rate of absorption is equal to 2303 C divided by Na H eta integral over nu rho radiation of nu epsilon of nu by nu d nu. Okay, now what I'm going to do is the following. Now think of it like this. You have an absorption spectrum, absorption as a function of lambda, you'll get some peak. Okay, now this I told you I can transform in a way that I can plot epsilon of nu versus nu, thing like that. Okay, so that's what I've done. Now when I record from say nu 1 to nu 2, which is the two ends of the spectrum, okay, then what I'll assume is that the rho radiation or the radiation density is constant. So radiation density is constant over the absorption band. Okay, band. Okay, if I, that is a constant, then which means this one I can bring it outside, because when you integrate, constants just get multiplied. So what you get is WFI is equal to 2303 C rho radiation of nu divided by Na H eta integral over nu epsilon of nu by nu d nu. Okay, now what you are doing is the, you get this, you get the rate constant. Okay, now we have two equations. Okay, one is the radiation density, so the, sorry, one is the rate constant rho fi is equal to 2303 C divided by Na H eta rho radiation of nu integral nu epsilon nu by nu d nu. Okay, but we know rate of absorption WFI per molecule is just given by B times rho radiation nu. Now when I equate these two constants, I'll get B equals to 2303 C divided by Na H eta integral nu epsilon nu by nu d nu. Okay, so I need to just get this integral. Now, what is this integral? Now, I told you that we could also have an absorption spectrum, okay, as a function of nu, epsilon nu. So, for each value of nu, there is a different epsilon. So, what you do is you divide epsilon nu by nu. So, what you do is you transform this plot as epsilon nu by nu into nu. So, if you plot that plot, and this area of this integral, okay, so this area is this integral. So, your rate B is 2303 times C, that's the speed of light, N A Avogadro constant, H eta, and this integral whatever is that you measure, nu, epsilon nu by nu. And this integral can be experimentally measured. Okay, so by measuring the extinction coefficient epsilon nu by nu, or other way around, so what we get is the following. Okay. Okay, your Einstein's coefficient B is given by 2303 C by Na H eta integral over nu epsilon nu by nu d nu. Okay. Now, you see B, that is Einstein's coefficient of absorption, is now proportional to the extinction coefficient. So, there is a relationship between the extinction coefficient and the absorption coefficient of the action. Similarly, one can write A is equal to, now A was nothing but 8 pi H nu cube by C cube, okay, B, so 2303 C by Na H eta integral nu epsilon nu by nu d nu. So, this C and becomes C square and this H get cancelled. So, what you get is 8 pi into 2303 divided by Na eta C square nu cube integral nu epsilon of nu by nu d nu. That's A. So, you can, by measuring the absorption spectrum and plotting, so when you measure the absorption spectrum, A versus lambda, you can transform it as epsilon of nu versus nu, which can again be transformed as epsilon of nu by nu by nu. So, one can do this transformation, and when you have this spectrum and this is nothing but this, okay, then you can actually calculate the Einstein's A coefficient and B coefficient. So, Einstein's A coefficient and B coefficient can be related to the absorption spectrum. Okay. Now, it turns out we also know that Einstein's A coefficient, B coefficient are also related to transient moment integral. So, we know B is not equal to pi by 6 epsilon naught h bar square f mu z I whole square. But this is same as 2303 C by Na h eta integral over nu epsilon over nu by nu d nu. Now, when you equate these two, so let us do that. So, pi by 6 epsilon naught h bar square, okay, f mu z I whole square is equal to 2303 C by Na H eta integral over nu epsilon nu by nu t nu. So which means your transient dipole f mu z epsilon I whole square equals to 6 epsilon naught h bar square by pi into 2303 C N A H eta integral over nu epsilon nu by nu d nu. Okay, now I can go on to do so. So this is equal to 6 epsilon naught h bar square is h square by 4 pi square. There is already pi, so 4 pi cube 2303 c by n a h eta. So this h and this square gets cancelled, this 4 2 times and 3 times 2 pi epsilon naught 2303. So this can one can write it as 3 by 2 epsilon naught pi square 2303 c by n a eta, there is a h on the bar, into h integral over nu epsilon nu by nu t nu. So one can think of the transient dipole moment L square is proportional to integral over nu epsilon over nu by nu t nu. Okay, this is the relationship that I wanted to bring. So epsilon nu is nothing but your extinction coefficient. Okay. So the transition dipole of a transition between state I and state F or state 1 and state 2 is proportional to this integral, which is made of extinction coefficient. So once we know extinction coefficient, or rather we know, so if you have a band, okay, and we know the integral underneath it, so the entire band integral, the way you plotted it is epsilon of nu by nu versus nu. If you know this integral, then this integral is proportional to your transient dipole. So if you have by the way, all these are constants, okay, except, you know, if you change the solvent, the refractive index will change. Other than that, everything else is a constant. Okay, so once you change the a transition from say molecule A to molecule B, if the area under the curve changes, then you know the transient moment, transient dipole is changing or not. So this is a theoretical quantity and this is an experimental quantity. So this is theory and this is experiment. Okay, so one can always relate the transient dipole to the extinction coefficient, not in a straight way, but, you know, in the kind of integral. So there is an integral here, but, you know, it is basically the entire transition extinction coefficient of a band, not exactly at one position, not at the peak or lambda max. It is the extinction coefficient over the entire band. Okay, so which can be experimentally measured using an absorption spectrum, and theoretically one can also get the transient dipole. So these two are related to each other. So we'll stop here and continue in the next lecture. Thank you.